Venice, La Serenissima. The most serene. Every year, 16 million visitors arrive to marvel at its architectural wonders and grand canals. Boats are the only traffic in this island city. Sightseers, commuters, deliveries, even the emergency services. Everyone and everything travels by water. Venice sits in a huge saltwater lagoon on the edge of the Adriatic Sea. And it's a city under siege. Salt water now floods half of Venice most years, causing millions of dollars of damage. They call these floods Acqua Alta, or high water. Geologists like Guido Giordano know that with sea levels rising, Venice is living on borrowed time.
Venice gets flooded not simply from the canals, but also from the ground when the water rises.
As the flooding is becoming more and more frequent,
the city is in real danger of becoming a modern-day Atlantis.
Today, engineers race to repair Venice's sinking buildings. They are also constructing an extraordinary new flood barrier to protect the city. But it's about more than keeping Venice safe for its inhabitants. They must also preserve some of the most important historic buildings in the world. The Byzantine Basilica in St. Mark's Square. The Church of Gold. Erected in 1063, then added to over time, it's one of the most dazzling buildings in Venice. The Venetians pillaged marble from the east, adding it to the basilica over 100 years after the church was originally built. The basilica's 60-foot-tall cupolas, built in the 13th century, enrich its imposing profile. Its decoration proclaims the status and glory of the ancient Venetian Republic. But today, its grandeur is at risk of being destroyed by the devastating floods.